Welcome all. Today I will be talking about N-heterocyclic carbenes and their catalysis. So in this particular presentation, I will be talking about NHCs, what are N-heterocyclic carbenes, and then I'll briefly mention about their use in modern organic synthesis. So carbenes are very popular reaction intermediates. We know there are two different kinds of carbene available. One is singlet carbene. One is triplet carbene, and these are electrophilic species having 6 electrons in this particular carbene-carbon atom. So these 6 electrons can be accommodated in 2 different orbitals having one single electrons, or maybe a lone pair and a vacant orbital. So these orbitals are generally a vacant p orbital for singlet carbene and a filled sp2 orbital. In the case of triplet carbene, both p orbital and sp2 orbitals are singly occupied. Now the crucial thing here is the bond angle between R dashed C R. If the carbene is singlet carbene that has a lone pair, and thus this lone pair and the C R bond pair repulsion is very high, and thus this particular bond angle is quite high, and which decreases the bond angle between R C R dash, and it is generally 110 degrees. So then the carbene is bent carbene and it has a singlet nature. Whereas if it is a singly occupied orbital, then the repulsion between a singly occupied orbital and a bond pair is comparatively less than the bond pair lone pair repulsion, and thus it has a very comparatively high R dash C R bond angle, approximately near 130 degrees, and this is triplet carbene. So both carbenes are electrophilic species and it can generally react with a nucleophile. So N-heterocyclic carbene is a type of singlet carbene having a bent structure and it has a cyclic nature. So this cyclic molecule has embedded a nitrogen or any other heteroatomic atom in the adjacent position to the carbene carbon, which stabilizes this particular carbene. So N substituents are also important, and this may be alkyl or aryl groups. So all these things I will discuss little later, but first I will talk about the first bottle level carbene. So first bottle level NHC carbene was reported by the group of Arduengo, where he used a imidazolium salt of adamantane derivative, and this one first he deprotonated with sodium hydride base, which leads to the stable NHC. As this is going through a ionic mechanism, that is through a deprotonation, so easily you can understand due to the mechanism it is generating a single carbene. So that is also one particular property that is embedded with NHC. So if we are going to generate a carbene through a ionic mechanism, it generally gives us the singlet carbene. Now you can see the features of NHCs. So NHC, that particular geometry, molecular structure and orbitals play an important role in its characteristics. So the carbene carbon has one vacant p orbital and a filled sp2 orbital. And in the adjacent position, we have a nitrogen atom having a filled p orbital, and in the other side also it may be existing. It may not be necessarily in the both position. But the major important thing is that interaction between this lone pair of nitrogen and the vacant p orbital, which can give us a resonating structure, and this structure is generally this one. So here we can get a ionic form of this NHC, where if this two orbital form a double bond, then we have this sp2 lone pair available in the carbene carbon center, and thus it can act as a nucleophile having a anionic charge. And the structural features are very important. So first is the backbone, and as this backbone is a cyclic backbone, so it is giving us a bend structure. And as we have already discussed, that this bond angle NCN is very crucial for getting a stable singlet carbene. So in cyclic molecules, generally we have a very strained structure, and this bond angle is quite low compared to the expected one in sp3 or sp2 orbitals. So it gives us a stable singlet carbene, and the structure is obviously influencing the carbene electronics because of its various orbital interactions. Second thing is the nitrogen substituent. So we know that carbene carbons are very much reactive, and if we do not have anything in the reaction media, carbene can dimerize itself to give us a olefin. So if we put a bulky substituent in the nitrogen atom, then it can kinetically stabilize that particular NHC, and it inhibits that particular NHC from dimerization. Second thing is the electronic influence. So the substituent can electronically influence the nitrogen atom, as this is adjacent, and thus in indirect way it can stabilize the carbene or destabilize the carbene. And the third thing possible is the generation of chirality. If we put a chiral center in this R group, obviously this, because of this chiral nature of this carbene, we can generate asymmetry. Third thing is the N heteroatom. So N heteroatom, already have discussed that this has a very interesting feature, that it can interact through a pi electron donation. Another electronic feature is the sigma electron withdrawing nature. So in this structure, if we see, this has sigma electron withdrawing group, that is inductively withdrawing group, and thus it can stabilize the anionic molecule. So this is also an interesting feature. So overall, it gives us an inductive mesomeric stabilization to this NHC. Now the fourth thing is the ring structure. So bend structure is important to stabilize the singlet carbene, otherwise it will be converted to a triplet carbene. And the ring geometry influences the steric and electronic nature of the overall carbene catalysis. Over the years, various N-heterocyclic carbenes have been reported in literature, and one of the most popular one is this particular imidazolyl derivative, which is used in Grubbs second generation catalyst. In this particular carbene, they have a mesityl group substituent in the nitrogen atom. Other than that, we have a bench imidazolyl derivative of a NHC, or we may have a imidazolyl derivative of NHC, where in one side we have a nitrogen atom near to the carbene-carbon, and in the other side we have a carbanion species, and both of them can stabilize the carbene-carbon. And other type carbenes are also there, where in one side we have a nitrogen atom and in the other side we have a carbene alkyl group, and this type of carbenes are called CAC carbene, and these are also a very popular variant of NHC. It is always not necessarily the carbene structure should be a 5-member ring, it may be a 6-member ring also, and here I have shown a popular example of 6-member cyclic N heterocyclic carbene. And this is called DAC carbene, where two amino groups are present in the adjacent position to the carbene-carbon. And as these are amino groups, the electron donation from nitrogen to carbene-carbon is different from regular NHCs, and thus it has a different electronic feature. Also, this is a 6-member cyclic structure, so it has a different steric feature also. I have already told that carbenes can induce chirality during its reaction. So if we have a chiral group in the ring structure, that can influence chirality in the reaction. And also the N substituents having a chiral functionality can also lead to chiral center generation. And overall, C2 symmetry is very crucial in this particular type of catalyst, which can reduce the number of diastereomeric transition states and can lead to specific C2 selectivity. Now coming to NHC carbene organocatalysis. So I have already told you that NHCs can stay in its ionic form in this particular structure, and this particular carbene is now is a anion. So this anionic carbene now can interact with aldehydes or any other carbonyl compounds, and it can lead to a molecule where that carbene can attack to the carbonyl center, and this nucleophilic addition will give us this particular structure. In this particular structure, if you look, this carbon has a electron withdrawing group because this carbene is now positively charged, and thus the acidity of this particular proton is high, and it can be converted to a carbanion. And this is almost similar to the classical benzoin condensation, where a carbonyl del positive charge is converted to carbanion, that is an Ampoulang reactivity. Now this carbanion can also stay in its mesomeric form, and these intermediates are called Brasillo intermediates. These intermediates, in presence of an electrophile, can react with the electrophile to give electrophilic substitution, and thus it can lead us to this particular structure. In the structure, this imidazolyl group is now a very good leaving group, and finally substitution through this particular OH group can give us the carbonyl compound with a electrophilic substitution in this carbonyl carbon and NHC pack. And this NHC can again catalyze the reaction further. Similarly, if we have a alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, similar trend of reactivity can be observed, and it can lead to this particular type of attack. And then it can lead to the Breslau intermediate, and this Breslau type intermediate in presence of a electrophile can be trapped in its gamma position, and thus it will give us this particular structure. And now from this we can get back the aldehyde and the carbene, so we can easily change the character of this particular beta carbon of the aldehyde, and we can get electrophilic substitution in that particular position. Now I'll be discussing a recent report from Professor Robin Chi group, where they have utilized this NHC carbene catalysis for the construction of all carbon quaternary chiral center. And in this method, they have used a vinylogas nucleophile, which I will discuss during the mechanism studies, and this lead to a 4+2 cyclization, which generates a benzenoid structure, and such kind of bending ring formation from acyclic molecules are pretty important in organic synthesis. And this particular reaction is mainly catalyzed by this particular type of NHC carbene. They have also screened various carbene precursors, and you can see they have utilized carbene precursor having a CH bond in this imidazolyl salt, which can be deprotonated in the reaction medium using a base. So here mainly they have used CGM carbonate as base, but other bases such as DBU, DIPA or DIEA, which is a diisopropyl ethylamine, sodium acetate and potassium carbonate, were not very effective. Various carbenes were also tested, and most of them were not effective to generate high enantiomer selective ratio. However, here this particular type of carbene, G type carbene, has given very high yield with very high enantiomeric ratio. So now I'll be talking on the mechanism. If we look at the mechanism, it is pretty similar to the earlier version, whatever I have discussed already. So NHC carbene can react with the alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde to generate a Breslau type intermediate. Now in presence of this quinone type oxidant, it can undergo oxidative transformation in this particular position to generate the carbonyl compound. Now in this carbonyl compound, you can see the methyl group is pretty activated because this carbene derivative is now acting as a very strong electron withdrawing group, and thus this gamma CH3 bond can be deprotonated in presence of a base, which lead to the formation of an enolate. And this enolate type molecule can interact with this cyclopentene diones molecule, and this Michael type addition gives us to another enolate formation during the reaction medium. So now this enolate can attack to this particular carbonyl moiety through a intramolecular aldol type reaction and can construct this kind of six member ring. And this six member ring have an anionic molecule oxygen atom which comes back and remove the NHC group as a leaving group and regenerate the catalyst, and ultimately we get this particular type of compound. In this compound we have a ketonic molecule which in presence of oxidative conditions can undergo aromatization to give us the particular benzenoid structure. And now facial selectivity is pretty easy to understand because of this bulky substituent in the NHC. This cyclopentene dione molecule comes from the top face of this enolate, and the substitution pattern in this particular cyclopentene dione is also realizable because this benzyl group is a bulkier substituent compared to the methyl group, thus it prefers to stay on the above face compared to the bottom face, and thus the nucleophilic attack happens from the bottom face of the cyclopentene dione, and it leads to such kind of chiral lytic generation. And ultimately this is a example of asymmetric desymmetrization of the cyclopentene dione molecules, where we are using a achiral molecule and generating chiral center from that through a desymmetrization process. Now with this particular condition, they have checked the scope of substrates, and this reaction is pretty effective, and in most of the cases they have observed almost 90:10 enantiomeric ratio in the product formation. In most of the cases it is maintained, however in certain cases where you can see this nitro derivative or this kind of molecules where they have a bromo derivative, they have a little bit lesser enantiomeric ratio. When they screen the cyclopentene dione derivatives having a cyclic structure in this particular quaternary carbon, there the enantioselective ratio or enantiomeric ratio is quite less, and in this particular spirocyclic structure they have almost a racemic mixture was obtained. This is totally understandable because these are having less higher steric nature compared to the free variants. Now with these products they have performed some synthetic transformation. So first they have taken this nitro derivative of this product and first reduced it with a iron powder acetic acid, which can reduce this nitro group to NH2 group, and under the acidic condition it can undergo imine formation with this carbonyl to generate this kind of molecule. They have also synthesized the methoxy variant of this particular variant molecule, where they first product this free OH group with the methyl iodide to generate the methoxy functionality, and then they have performed the similar transformation to generate a methoxy variant. And you can see in both of the cases almost similar enantiomeric ratio was maintained, and the change is quite less. Similar type transformation they have also performed with another variant, where they have first protected the OH group with methyl iodide to get the methoxy functionality, and then they have reduced this to carbonyl groups with lithium aluminum hydride, so it gives us the benzylic alcohols. Now they have employed a polyphosphoric acid in the reaction medium, which leads to the generation of carbocations in the benzylic position. These carbocations can undergo electrophilic substitution in the aromatic ring, which is generally called Friedel-Crafts alkylation, and can gives us this complex molecular structure. having a chiral center here. And overall yield for these three steps are quite high, almost 62%, and dash to numeric ratio as well as enantiomeric ratio is quite high. So today I have discussed a NaC carbene catalysis. Hope this has helped you. If you have liked the video, please share it with others so that many people can get to know about the recent trends in NaC catalysis. Thank you.